Good day to you. Let's talk about the inductive effect and how the inductive effect or induction can stabilize charges. So again, we have two acid-base reactions on the screen. In the top case, we have a molecule called ethanol, and the lower case is called 2-chloroethanol. They're very similar. They both have deprotonation by a base, and they both form very similar O minuses in their product. So you might say, both have an O minus. The electronegativity of the atom that bears a charge is the same. The size of the atom that bears a charge is the same. There are no resonance effects in these two situations. So you'd think that these would have very similar basicities. And if the stability of the conjugate base is the same, then the strength of the acid, corresponding acid, should be the same. Turns out they're a little bit different. One is 16 and one is 14. So the difference must be due to this chlorine in the molecule. That's the only difference between these molecules. So this is a carbon-chlorine bond that we've drawn here. This carbon-chlorine bond is a covalent bond, so that means the electrons are shared. Yes, they are. Are they shared equally? No, they are not, because chlorine is more electronegative than carbon. And so the way we show this, we say this is a polarized bond. And we can draw an arrow like this that indicates that is a polarized bond. Well, what is the effect of that polarization? That electron density is tilted towards the chlorine. So even though the electrons are shared, chlorine gets a little bit more of that electron density. It's going to have a partial negative charge relative to the carbon. So the carbon is going to have the corresponding partial positive charge. Now, it's this creation of partial positives and partial negatives. This is where the inductive effect arises. So this partial plus on this carbon, because it's in close proximity to our O minus, it actually has a stabilizing effect on the O minus. It makes this O minus more stable. So if that O minus is more stable, what are we saying? It is less reactive. Less reactive how? It is less basic. And so if this conjugate base is less basic, that means the corresponding acid should be a stronger acid. And sure enough, that's borne out by the fact that that acid has a lower pKa, indicating that it is indeed more acidic. Not by a ton, by a little bit. In theory, if we added two chlorines to this particular carbon, or three chlorines, we should see even a more pronounced inductive effect. Now, inductive effects tend to be somewhat weak, and they tend not to transmit through a lot of carbon. So if you had this molecule, I'll just draw a line angle structure, you wouldn't expect this hydrogen to feel the effect of this chlorine very much because they're so far apart. Things need to be close together for the inductive effect to have a big effect. But the inductive effect is very important. It's right behind resonance, and we'll see this pretty frequently as being a driver for stabilizing charges in our molecules.